Praise the Lord. My name is Mark Van Gundy. It's my wife, Mary. We're from Truth Vine Church and also Betty King International Ministries. And we just want to share with you about marriage today. And God, it's God's plan. Genesis 1:26 says, let us make man in our image according to their likeness. And then verse 28 says, he blessed them saying, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth. God wanted to fill the earth with his presence. Yeah, Habakkuk says that the whole earth is going to be filled with the glory of God like the waters cover the sea. So in looking at marriage, God wants his presence, us to carry his presence, but inhabit his presence. And also, you know, to host his presence in our marriages, in our homes. But it's God's idea. And so we're going to see blessings come upon that. He even spoke blessings over them. Isn't that right, darling?
Amen. Absolutely. Praise God. We thank God for marriage. It's his idea, and there's a grace to walk in marriage together. Praise God. And, you know, we don't have to, there's so many books have been written on marriage. There's hundreds of books about it. But, you know, as I was thinking about this, just three kind of things came to mind. And, you know, the first thing is fear. It's the fear of the Lord. You know how the Bible says that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And you may think, well, what is the fear of the Lord? And really, in a nutshell, it's loving God and wanting to please him more than anybody else. And whatever he says, wanting to do that. And wisdom is knowing what God wants you to say or do, really, at any given time. And so I think the key with marriage, yes, there's some wonderful books, and we want to learn about different things, you know, which are written about marriage. But the thing is, we have to have God first. You know how in Revelation it says that I have something against you, that you've lost your first love. And that with any relationship, the key is to have God first. And when he's first, then all these other things will flow out of it. And also, the second thing, it's like for, F-O-R. And the second thing is overflow. That when two people come together, it's not two halves coming to make it complete. It's like one complete person, another complete person coming together. And how it's not, how can he make me feel happy? How can he meet my needs? But it's about going to God and letting him minister to us. And then out of that, there's an overflow. And so once you, God will meet your needs, he will bless you, he will fill you with peace. You know, I remember a lady came to me and she must have had 50 things on her list for what she wanted in her husband. You know, and I said, you know, you don't need a husband, you need Jesus, you know. And it's only Jesus can meet our needs. But then as he does, then we have something left to minister to others after, to our husband. And the third thing was our respect. You know, and it's like, it's you're respecting the person, but you're also respecting the office of a husband, yes? And you may think, well, what happens if the husband thinks one way and the wife thinks another? Well, you pray about it, you give it to the Lord, and then, you know, if the husband makes the decision and maybe the wife doesn't feel, but you respect him, you say what you feel, you pray about it, and then you honor that position of a husband. And, you know, there's loads of other things. You know, sometimes it's like marriage, it's the only thing we go into, and we think, oh, we don't need any training for that. And everything else in life we do, we get trained, we learn, we study, and, you know, I just... encourage you to, you know, get books about it and learn about different things. You know, the thing about respect, my grandfather was married for 64 years, and I always remember he said, every day I do something to build my marriage. And I said, well, you know, Granddad, you've been married all these years, I think you can relax now. But he said, marriage is confounder of small things like bad manners. You know, when someone's talking and the other one's on their phone, or, you know, you're saying something and not really engaging. So I think, you know, those are kind of things which really help to form like a foundation for this. But the foundation really is Jesus.
Yes, it's the Word of God. Ephesians talks about Ephesians 5. Really the best blueprint for us today is the Word of God, especially epistles. Ephesians 5, he's talking about wives submitting to husbands, and usually men always mention that. And I like to look at word submit is sort of like, and in the verse before it says submitting to one another. So even the husband is to submit to the wife also. In other words, I see submit like you have the mission, submission. You serve, I serve my wife's mission. She serves my mission. In fact, we try to work on how we can outserve. But I love it. He says, husbands, love your wives. And this is hard, as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. In other words, it's sacrificial love, laying down your life, praying for one, encouraging one another. When one's down, the other's up. But the whole key, I believe, is built on the word of God. Because he says that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing by the word. And so it must be built on the word of God. It's communication. Hearing from heaven. So we read the word of God. We're hearing what God says about our home. In other words, our home, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, or reflect heaven. Heaven's to be released through our marriage, through the husband and the wife serving one another. But it also is and he talked about presenting himself a glorious church or a glorious marriage. He's talking about the home, family, and marriage. And he's also talking about the church. The marriage is to be a picture of the church. The church is to be a picture of marriage. And so we need to reflect the glory of God, the presence of God. And so we need to hear from heaven by getting in the word of God, receive training, and also through prayer, talking to him, praying together, building an altar, a family altar of prayer. We pray together. We have our own quiet times, our own time with the Lord. We get together and pray together, pray for our family, pray for our children. They're all grown up now. They're going to be having their own families, but that's the will of God. And he wants to fill the earth with his presence. He has a plan and a purpose and a calling on every one of us. And we want to reflect that and serve the Lord, serving one another with his goodness and mercy and his love and his faith. And it's all by grace. We just, you know, the only way I can love my wife the way Christ loved the church is, Lord, fill me up with your love. Help me to do this because it's impossible for me to do it in my own strength. Don't you think so?
And I think to guard unity in your home, you know, it's not about who's right, but it's about preserving that unity and that love. Because where you have strife, you have confusion in every evil work. And to wait for each other. You know, if there's a situation you're facing, pray about it. And sometimes one God will speak to one before the other, or the other, you know, but just to wait for each other and then to walk together, you know, but to preserve that. And also, my husband is so good at this, about forgiveness. He is so quick to forgive. And he said, I'm sorry I've upset you. And it doesn't mean, you know, it's about being real together and, you know, and just preserving that love.
Because my mother, we would get a smack if we didn't forgive. We had to learn to forgive from an early age. You must forgive. And so I had it drilled into me, forgiveness.
Yes, and you know, unforgiveness, the price on it is so high, it's just not worth it. And just to have peace. You know, the dictionary says that home is a place of rest and refuge. And that's what we need to have, that place of peace. And you know,
God's presence filling our home. You know, the key is built on the word of God and the presence of God. And the Lord, the Holy Spirit, will help you to be a good husband, to be a good wife, to serve one another, and then reflect and reach to others, reach out to others, making your home that place, that refuge.
Yes, yes. And I mean, you will say things which upset each other. You will, but it's just saying sorry and, you know, getting back into that unity in your home. Because your home is a place not just for you, but you know how... it says in the word about that everyone will own a home of their own to invite the neighbors in. That's in the Message Bible.
Yeah,
and, you know, we want a home to be a place we can invite the neighbors in and they can get to know Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. God is so good. He's so faithful. Hallelujah. It's a learning thing. You know, every day we're learning and, you know, about loving Jesus more and loving each other more. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
And you're blessed. And if you're married, God is going to bless you.
Maybe we should pray. You want to pray?
Okay. Father, I just thank you for my brother and sister who are watching. And I thank you, Father, that you have the best for them, that you have such good plans for them. And Lord, if they're married or they're preparing to get married, we thank you that there's a grace for marriage, that marriage was your idea and that it is good. And so we thank you, Father, that as they prepare for marriage, that Lord, you will, that you're sort of ironing out the wrinkles. You're getting us ready so that we can provoke this person to love and good works, so that as we can be a spouse, which will be able to minister out of the overflow to the other one. And Father, I just thank you for those who are in marriage and maybe those who are feeling like this is so hard. I thank you, Lord, that you will pour in the oil. Lord, that the oil makes the wheels turn quickly when things are a bit hard going. I thank you for oil. Thank you for the oil of joy. Thank you that your joy gives strength in every situation. Bless them abundantly and let there be hope. Thank you that the best truly is yet to come. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Love you.